This is Dunagun Kaiser, founder of Liberty and Finance. I'm now a licensed gold and silver broker for Miles Franklin. Call me directly for the physical gold and silver that you need at the best price with personalized private service from one of the oldest and best companies in the business. For fastest service, just call 1-888-81-LIBERTY. That's 888-81-LIBERTY. And either I or one of my sons and fellow brokers will call you back as soon as we can and understand your needs. Welcome to a behind-the-scenes tour of the Miles Franklin Bullion Operations presented by Liberty and Finance. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for joining us. If you joined us for the first episode of Inside the Vault with Miles Franklin CEO Andy Schectman, inside the vault of the Miles Franklin storage facility in the Midwest of the U.S., you got a chance to hear a lot about different concerns about storage and how Miles Franklin can help with that. But now we're going to show you much more of the operations that we observed while we were there on site with Dunagun Kaiser from Liberty and Finance visiting Miles Franklin's bullion operations in the Midwest. Incoming to the bullion operations includes scrap sterling silver that's received from people who sell, whether it's family heirlooms or it can be purchased from scrap dealers. But we got to see them opening up a cask containing a wide variety of sterling silvers. Silverware, cups, plates, goblets, all kinds of different pieces of sterling silver. These were all going to be inspected and then melted down to reclaim their silver. We also got to see circulated silver, such as Walker Liberty coins and other worn-out culls from American Constitutional silver being poured into a kiln, which had been fired up to a melting temperature before doing both a silver melt, and we'll also be showing you a gold melt in just a minute. But here you see the actual reclaimed circulated silver coins from many various eras being poured into the furnace and brought up to temperature until they become molten. When they're ready to be poured, they're going to be poured out into an ingot. The entire furnace itself, the whole kiln, can be tilted by a motorized apparatus until the molten silver comes out into the mold that's been prepared. The flames that you're seeing are actually a burn-off of the mold release agent that's added to the mold in order to keep the ingot able to be freed up after it's cooled, and it's not the metal itself, but just the high temperature of the molten metal igniting the mold release compound. And once this entire mold has been filled from the melt that's being poured, you can see that the ingot is starting to cool there in the mold. And in a moment, we're going to start a gold melt and pour. Once the gold has been melted in the kiln, they stir it to get even consistency before doing a quality and purity test. They're going to have to test it. It's extremely important. They take an evacuated cylinder of glass with a vacuum on the inside, dipping it down into the molten metal, and the heat breaks the glass, but the vacuum pulls a very fine sample of the molten gold up into the glass cylinder, where it is then tested by sophisticated laboratory equipment to determine the purity of the batch. Once the batch is ready, it's poured, this time a smaller mold for the smaller gold pour. This ingot will be formed. You get another view of it here, including the kiln master there. And once this ingot has also cooled, it is turned out and set next to the silver ingot for further cooling. The next step is going to be a quench of the silver ingot in order to completely finish the cooling process at a high speed and at a big temperature drop. So the silver ingot is transported over to a quench bath. Now it's time to quench the smaller gold ingot, which is also moved over to the quench bath and dropped rapidly in temperature. After this quenching process, it can be handled and inspected to make sure that the formation of the ingot is strong enough and complete enough. There the ingot is awaiting final analysis and final weighing before being added to a batch of gold ingots sent to refining. Here is smaller gold ingots that are being combined into a batch, and additional ingots are being measured.
What are the purity of those, roughly?
Well, so far,
stuff that's in this year, the net purity is 57.1125 out of those two bars. We'll actually see that number adjust as I add bars to it, the weighted average. So now I'm going to add another one to lot number 330.
We saw a wide variety of commercially produced silver ingots of various sizes in the vault, and we saw inspection of incoming gold for purity using a variety of techniques. One technique is an electromagnetic scanner that penetrates even bulk samples of gold and coins or bars with an electromagnetic wave that determines very accurately the percentage of the specific metals that you're looking for. In this case, a gold sample is being placed and it measures outside the range. This kind of quality control testing using this and other equipment enables Miles Franklin to make sure that every piece of metal that's sold is authentic and it's 100% guaranteed. We also got to see quite a bit of their inventories of sovereign mint bullion, including U.S. American silver eagles in individual coins, mint tubes, and mint monster boxes. We got to see Australian Royal Mint silver kangaroos, again, individual coins, mint tubes, and mint monster boxes. And constitutional silver from the U.S. Mint 1964 and prior. This is a receiving of a pallet of dimes and quarters of pre-1965 90% silver constitutional coins for sale. They come packaged in $1,000 face value bags, but they can be purchased in any amount of even face dollar value. You can see within that bag there's some quite old coins, some more recent, but all of them are going to be 1964 and older. It couldn't help but watch and look through those to see, as they move them around in the operations, all the various years that were in there, just bags of history right before our eyes. We also got to see $1,000 face value bags of half dollars and dollar coins. These bags, originally from the U.S. Mint and now available for purchase, had, again, 1964 and older half dollar coins, all of those in 90% silver. When any of these products are ordered for delivery, they go through an inspection and packaging process. Here, there are multiple closed circuit television cameras that record and document the packaging operation to ensure the quality and completeness of every package. When those packages are finished and ready to ship out, the UPS or other shipping trucks arrive, and many carts filled with packages extremely heavily taped and labeled and ready to go are scanned out by the shipper, starting the first in a series of custody handoffs that are tracked and insured all the way from the packing operation to the delivery to the final customer. Once every package has been scanned, it's time for the crew to help load up the truck. So multiple carts containing anywhere from dozens to hundreds of packages are handed off to the shipper, and the truck is loaded up to its capacity. With the weight of these shipments, it's not the volume capacity, but the weight capacity. The day we were observing was a relatively light day. Many days have three or more times as many carts and packages going out as what we were able to observe on this particular day. The generic return address label doesn't give any indication along the way that the packages contain high value contents, and a sophisticated multi-layer insurance strategy is used by only placing a nominal insurance on the package itself to make sure that they receive special handling, but then insuring the full value of the package through a third-party insurer so that none of the employees of the shipping company are aware of the full value of the packages for added privacy. Once the truck is up to its full weight limit or all the packages have been loaded, it's time for it to head on out, starting a chain of custody that's going to take all of those insured packages all the way to their destination, some of them to secure vault storage, and others for individuals to have in their physical possession. We also got to go inside the vault with Miles Franklin CEO Andy Schectman, and you can see much more of that episode inside their multi-layered military-grade vault by going to the Inside the Vault with Miles Franklin CEO Andy Schectman episode that you'll find a description and a link to in the description of this video. In Inside the vault, we got to see thousands of monster boxes of silver and other products that are stored on behalf of clients. And we got to speak with Miles Franklin's CEO, Andy Schectman, ask him lots of questions that you had submitted about storage in vaults and all the considerations of that for gold and silver. So check out that episode, Inside the Vault with Miles Franklin CEO Andy Schectman, on our channel. We hope you've enjoyed this behind-the-scenes sneak peek at the Miles Franklin Midwest Bullion Operations Hub and saw many of the things you may not have ever seen before. We certainly hadn't seen these things before, but glad we made the trip, glad we visited, and just thank you for joining us here again on Liberty and Finance. As always, guys, if you don't want to miss out on a single interview with Andy or any of our weekly specials that are always Tuesday night, 9 p.m. Eastern, and any of our guests, make sure you get on our mailing list. I continue to get emails from people saying that, oh, I'm getting shadow banned, they're not getting notifications from YouTube about new releases. Guys, you don't have to wait for YouTube to notify you. You just get on our website, libertyandfinance.com. First of all of our videos are going to be there. And secondly, you can just put in your name and email address and click submit and then respond to the confirmation email and you're in. We'll send you an email of every single interview that we have and any of the links or information that are available from our guests will be in there as well in the description. So don't miss out on anything. Go to libertyandfinance.com, sign up for our free email mailing list. This is Dunagun Kaiser, founder of Liberty and Finance. I'm now a licensed gold and silver broker for Miles Franklin. Call me directly for the physical gold and silver that you need at the best price with personalized private service from one of the oldest and best companies in the business. For fastest service, just call 1-888-81-LIBERTY. That's 888-81-LIBERTY. And either I or one of my sons and fellow brokers will call you back as soon as we can and understand your needs. Welcome back.